I started out doing a lot of cardiothoracic anesthesia here at Georgetown, and we noticed that we did use quite an amount of blood. There was always that teaching that more was better, and to keep everyone tanked up and keep that tank full. There was a push towards having everyone's hemoglobin be at least 10, kind of that magic number of 10. And then kind of the literature kind of caught up and practice kind of caught up, and people realized that the risk of infection was increasing, risk of side effects. I feel like past 10 years or so, it's been kind of a shift in paradigm shift in the use of blood. And we see it here at Georgetown as well, just looking at our numbers. You know, in 2006, 2007, we were transfusing over 15,000 units of packed red blood cells. And we've gotten now to 10, 11,000. So there's a drastic decrease in the usage of packed red blood cells with a same or increase in case mix index. So getting as sick or sicker patients still, getting better results with decreased use of blood products. We've seen decrease in infections. We've seen decrease in costs of our healthcare costs. We've seen better outcomes, just the tangible results. We don't always see that in medicine. You know, a lot of times things are pushed further down the road, but these tangible changes are really what drives us and drives our passion for this. And it starts with education. I think we found that out at Georgetown, educating our providers, educating the folks at the point of care that are giving the blood. And it's a very easy thing to do, and it doesn't take a lot of the technology that a lot of people think. And so the education point of it is easy to do. And as an anesthesiologist, the things that we do in the operating room are very easy. Cell salvage, meticulous hemostasis by the surgeons, acute normvolemic hemodilution that we do from an anesthesia standpoint. So many things that we can do that we already do, but we become more aggressive with doing, understanding that the less allogeneic blood that we give, usually the better results. The surgeons are very much on board as well, especially the surgeons that are spine surgeons, orthopedic surgeons, potential cases where there are a little bit more blood loss. They've seen the benefit of decreased use of blood. I think the approach that we're taking, a very multidisciplinary approach, is what really brings all of this together. You know, it's not just from an anesthesia standpoint or internal medicine or surgical. It's really everyone coming together for the benefit of the patient. You know, the ultimate goal is how we treat these patients and the outcome for these patients. And so as a provider, as a physician, all of us come together and realize that this really is beneficial, and working together with the other subspecialties and all of us really being on the same page is something that I think is, that's why I think it's so much fun to really work on.